Hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Welcome right into this Adobe After Effects tutorial where we're going to create this really cool video zooming through text type transition. It's really cool for like an intro of something. Check it out.
Moscow, Russia, 1986.
I just love it. It's actually pretty easy to do. I think you'll have some fun with it. If you do enjoy this tutorial, well, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel so you never miss any video editing After Effects or other tutorials in the past, present, or future. Let's jump into After Effects and get this thing started right now. All right, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and the plan is just to have some text zoom way in and shoot through the text and see this video that's going to be playing behind it. I have this beautiful shot of Moscow, Russia, and this is what we're going to use. So the first thing we'll do is we will right-click over here in our layers area. By the way, I have the video, and I've got sort of the sound hitter. Double tap L to bring up the waveform there. You can see there's that big slamming audio sound. And then the voiceover just where it's kind of the Russia, Moscow, or Moscow, Russia, whatever, however it went. So I've got all that stuff down there. You can use whatever underlying video. I got this from videoblocks.com. You can use whatever video and whatever audio you like. Just go out there and find stuff that works for you. I would share this if I could, but it's all stock stuff, so I can't really. I'm sorry about that. Let's go ahead and right-click and choose New, and I'm going to choose Solid here. I'm going to name this layer, I'm going to name it Cover Up, something like that. And the color is going to be black, and 2560 by 1440, that's the size of my document, so that's why it is 2560 by 1440. Hit OK. You can see it is covering up our video with black. Now we need to cut a hole in this using some text. So what I'll do is I will grab the text tool, and I will click once out here, and I'm going to type the word Russia. And I am going to grab my selection tool, and probably what I want to do first and foremost is just move the anchor point to the middle of the word Russia. So I'm going to hold down Command and Option, that would be Control and Alt on the PC, and I'm going to double tap the pan behind, or the anchor point tool there, and it's going to just reset that anchor point to the middle, just like that. And before we do anything else, let's go align, make sure we align this, number one, to the composition, and then align horizontally and vertically, just get it right in place. Then, before I come to character and start playing with the font and all of that, I'm going to go to paragraph and just make sure that I have it aligned center. Now when I start changing size and stuff like that in my character panel, I don't lose any information. Or not so much to lose information as knock this whole thing out of alignment. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go with the font that I have right here, Portico, and I'm going with the font style Rough Oblique, and it's kind of this cool textured looking font. You can really use anything you like. Just something that's big and bold and thick and fat. It will probably work better for this type of effect. But this is what I'm going with, and I'm going to set the size here to 350 pixels. So you can see it's quite large, and it still knocked us out of alignment, so I was wrong about that before. Let's just make sure we realign this whole thing. And just because I can, I'm going to change the fill color here to white, because I just kind of prefer that. That kind of white over black, the stark contrast, looks really nice. And that's kind of cool, just honestly, as it is. But we're not finished yet, because what I want to do is I want to essentially use this as a clipping mask of sorts to punch a hole in the black cover-up and show the video beneath. How are we going to do that? Well, down here at the bottom of the Layers panel, whoop, not Firefox, down here at the bottom of the Layers panel, we have Toggle Switches slash Modes. We're going to hit that button. And one of the things that happens when we hit the button is we have this Track Matte option that shows up. What we'll do here on the cover-up layer, use the Track Matte dropdown and choose to Alpha Matte Russia. But watch what happens. When we do this, you can see that it just makes the Russia letters turn black and it hides everything else. This isn't really what we want, is it? We actually want to go with Alpha Inverted Matte Russia. You can see all the black remains, but the text is working like a cookie cutter and just punching a hole in the middle of our black cover-up. If I sort of scrub through this, we can see all that stuff going on behind the black cover-up layer. Next, what I want to do is right-click and choose New and choose a new camera. And here, I'm going to go with the 50mm preset. It's kind of a cool-looking little dialog box here, but don't worry, it's not too overly complicated. We're going to go ahead and hit OK. And I get a warning here in After Effects saying, look, camera and lights, they don't affect 2D layers. Select a layer and choose Layer 3D. Okay, that's fine. We'll get on that in a moment, After Effects. Don't worry about that. And what I want to do here is come over here to the one view and choose the two view horizontal layout. So what we've got over here is, I can zoom in just a little bit more than this. Let's go to, I'm on the active camera. I don't want that. I like that being at 50%. Let's go to the top view, and instead of 6.25%, let's bring that also, maybe not 50% actually. Let's go back to like 25%. I still want to see the camera. So there's the camera, and maybe I should bring it back a little bit further. Maybe 6.25. I had a point. So here I've got the camera, and we can see this little white box. That's the camera, and the field of view is this whole triangle where it is pointing from the top down at the very top of these Russia letters, if you can envision that being in 3D space. And what we want to do is zoom in on the words Russia. So I can grab the little blue arrow. See how my mouse says Z? The Z axis pushes the camera in or out. I can zoom in, but watch what happens. When I zoom this camera in, absolutely nothing happens. That's because, if you recall a moment ago, when After Effects said, hey, look, you need some 3D layers, it's because we don't have our Russia text set to a 3D layer. So let's come back down to toggle switches slash modes, select that, and we can come here on the Russia layer and just tick on this checkbox underneath this 3D cube. That's going to make this a 3D layer, or 3D capable layer. And now as I zoom the camera in, you can see how our text zooms in as well, right? As the camera gets closer, that sort of red line there, that's the top edge, if you will, of the text. So I'm just going to undo my camera movement because we want to animate this to make this effect really work. So what we'll do is we'll come here to our camera, and I'm going to hit the little twirly down arrow, and I'm going to twirl down camera options. And what I'm going to do here is hit the letter P to bring up positioning. The position I'm most interested in is not the X or the Y, but rather the third option, or the third parameter here, third input maybe I should say, the Z axis. I am going to set this to -17,000. So very small. We're way, way back. I could probably go to 3% and maybe I could see. There's the camera way far away from the text. You can see how small the text looks. That's perfect. I'm now going to drop a keyframe by hitting the little stopwatch. It's going to toggle on the animation and drop that little diamond, that little keyframe. And what I want to do, I want the text to finally end up exploding through the screen and showing all of the video at the same time that our sound hitter is really exploding. So I'll select bad hit here, double tap L, and we can see right here, right around 1 second is when the sound really peaks for us. So I'm going to take the Z position, I'm going to change it from 17,000, I'm going to bring it all the way down to like -5. You can see how it's moving it way in past our video. And now as I zoom back out, I can see the movement of the camera. Now, just a quick tip. As you're doing this, your camera might end up like flipping an inverting triangle and be like pointing back the wrong way. If that happens, it's a really quick fix. Right click on camera one and you would go transform, choose auto orient, and just make sure auto orient is set to off. We don't want that on. Normally it's like orient towards point of interest. Just shut it off if you're having that problem and it'll go away. Next, I'll select both of these keyframes by holding down shift and selecting both of them. And I'm just going to simply hit F9 to give this like an easy ease, which is going to just make it a little smoother. And we can go back here and just go to one view again, so we can just watch our single view. And I think at this point we can go ahead and try previewing this, see what it looks like and how it sounds and all of that. So I'm going to hit up here in the preview menu. I have it set to go full screen when I hit spacebar. So I'm going to hit spacebar here and we will preview this. Moscow. And I think that looks pretty good. All the timing lines up pretty nicely. I kind of dig it. One little thing that I might want to do is here, right where everything begins, there's still the word Russia right there. So let's just kind of fade that up from 0% opacity. I'm going to collapse my layers here. I'm going to open up the Russia text. And in fact, I'll just select the Russia text and hit the letter T, which is going to bring me to my opacity transformation. And I'm going to click on the stopwatch to toggle animation. I'll come out. Actually, no, I'm going to go like 3 frames or something. So I'm going to hold down Command or Control and hit my right arrow key, 1, 2, 3 times, let's say. And we're going to drop another keyframe by hitting the little diamond there. Now we'll hit the previous keyframe button right here. That's going to take me back to that first keyframe. And on the first keyframe, we'll reduce the opacity to 0%. So what we'll have now is that text fade up from nothing and then zoom through and explode into the scene, just like that.
Moscow, Russia, 1986.
So yeah, pretty cool. That's going to be it for this one. Again, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you subscribe here on the YouTube channel. And if you're feeling ambitious, we just started a Discord server, so you can check out. There's a link for that down in the bio. We're getting a nice little community going there. We're going to be doing some fun stuff heading into the future. So check that out. Make sure you jump on in and join us over there on Discord as well. So for working with text and masks and some animation and 3D cameras and all the other fun stuff we covered in this video and more, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.